again. I guess many of you will use Stellarium for finding objects in the sky, choosing what to image and the like, and to see what's going to be in the sky on a particular night. And you've probably discovered that Stellarium has landscapes within it. This one here is called the Zero Horizon. If you go to Sky and Viewing Options on the left hand side here and go to the Landscapes tab, you can choose various different horizons. Here's an example called Trees. I'll just close that tab. You can see it's got a landscape with trees, and obviously Zero Horizon is a zero horizon, not terribly gripping. But wouldn't it be great if what it showed you was actually what you see from your imaging site? And you can do that, and you do it with what's called a custom landscape. So this video is a tutorial that shows you how to make a custom landscape and install it into Stellarium. So I've set up a tripod on the site where I do my imaging and set the height to match the height of my telescope, but I've mounted my iPhone on the top on a ball joint or an Arca-Swiss plate with a smartphone mount called an ULANZI ST04, quite cheap but very good, has a nice ball clamp on it. Lets you put the phone in portrait mode, so you can put it in panorama mode and take a shot, a panorama shot. And you need to make sure you get the highest obstruction in, and that's the top of my house to the north in my case. So I check on the screen when I'm pointing north that I can just see sky above the top of the house. A little difficult to see here on the video, but once that's set up and everything's level, I turn the camera to the west. I shoot one panorama going from west to east through north, and then shoot another one going from east to west through south. You can also do three or four if you want to and join multiple ones together. In the demonstration I'm going to use three separate photos taken when it was cloudier than this. Okay, now I'm actually going to show you how to process these images into a landscape using some images I took when it wasn't so sunny. It's definitely gives better results if you get these photos taken on a nice cloudy day without the glare of the sun. So these are the three pictures that I've taken, and I'm going to check how wide they are. They're about 3,000 pixels wide. If your panorama pictures are really wide, much wider than that, then resize them down all by the same amount. Then I'm going to make a new blank image, which is 10,000 pixels wide, 5,000 pixels high, RGB. And then I'm going to select each of these images, so Control A, Control C, select and copy, into here, and Control V, paste it in. Next image, Control A, Control C, Control V, and the final one, Control A, Control C, Control V. So you see I've got three different layers now, and I can move these about. So the central one will move to the top and put that in the middle, and then we'll move the others. So this one's going to be roughly here, and this one is going to be roughly there. So we'll now zoom in and refine those positions. So I'm going to use the leaves on the trees up here to help me get those more accurately into position. That looks fairly close. And then select the there on the left. And you will find if there's some spherical aberrations, or if your mount wasn't quite level or your camera wasn't quite upright, that you may get some misalignments. And you can see here I can line up the clothes dryer and the fence, but then the shed is not right. Or I can line up the shed and then the clothes dryer is not right. So just do the best that you can. It's the horizon that's the main thing that you're interested in, remember that. Okay, so I've aligned them with one another. Next thing to do is to make any brightness adjustments that you want to make. So I can see that I've got a good match in brightness between the middle image and the right hand image, but my left hand image is a little bright. So I'm going to adjust the brightness on that one just to try and get that a bit better matched. That looks much better. Okay, so now I'm going to merge the layers by doing layer flatten image. So now we have a single layer with everything on it. And now I'm going to do a crop. So I'm going to crop roughly from the same point on the left. You see my barbecue is on the left and also appears over here. So I'm going to zoom in and on the barbecue on the left side, and I'm going to adjust the crop point to match this line in the bricks. I'll just use that as a convenient reference point. And then I'm going to go over to the right hand side of the image, and I'm going to crop to the same line in the bricks, and then I'm going to zoom out. And in the vertical crop, I'm not going to crop anything at all, so I'm just going to keep all of this and all of this, and then hit OK. Tick the box. Right, so we've now got the point on the left edge of the image and the point on the right edge of the image are the same place. And now we will do an image size again. This time we're going to be 2048 pixels wide. So we're going to want to have 1024 pixels as the image height, and we want the, if you like, the eye line of the telescope to be in the middle of that. So if we just temporarily move what the top or bottom crop edge down to what we think is about the eye line of the telescope in the image, which I think is probably, for me, about here. And now I'm going to move the bottom crop edge until my height is 512, because that's half the total image height that I want. So just move that to 512. If you can't get exactly on 512, just zoom in a bit and you'll get more fidelity. Get to exactly 512. And let go. And now we'll zoom out. And we're going to move the top crop now back up until the total image height is 1024 pixels, which is almost there. 1 pixel. 102. 4. Okay, so now it's 2048 by 1024, and I hit the tick button to accept the crop. Okay, so next thing to do is going to draw a black rectangle to clean up this bottom edge of the image and fill everything in black. So we'll select the foreground color, make sure it's black, okay, and we're in rectangle mode, and I shall draw a rectangle right across there. And close this box, and that's that done. And then I'm going to do a layer flatten image, so we're back to having a flat image again. So now we need to select the sky, so I'm going to use the magic wand tool to select the sky. You'll need to experiment with the threshold on the magic wand tool. You can also use the lasso tool if you wish to. So magic wand, and then I'm going to unlock the background layer here, and then delete what I've selected, and then use some more magic wand to select additional areas that it missed. Delete those, and do Control D to unselect. Now I can use the lasso tool to do a bit of a clean up on there, just a rough clean up. Some of the stuff I've missed and delete. And now we'll zoom in a bit further and do a bit more of a cleanup. Back to the magic wand tool, missed an area there, a few areas here, do the tidying up and scrolling across. Area down here that needs improving. One up there, one here. and so on, and work your way across the image, making sure that you're happy that you've removed all of the sky wherever you want it removed. Get little bits like this that have been left behind, just lasso them and delete them. Control D to unselect. Quite a big area here, grab that with a magic wand. Delete that. And a few more areas here that have been missed, so again, magic wand to remove those. Okay, that's pretty much the sky deleted now. We'll zoom back out. You do get little areas of blotchy bits like this, so it's probably better to lasso them out rather than leave them in. They look a bit unsightly when you get into Stellarium. Just remove those using the lasso tool. And once you're happy, export as a PNG. So make sure you've got PNG and transparency selected, and then click export, and then choose your folder. And we're going to make a file called landscape.png and hit save. I already had one before, so I'm overwriting it. Okay, so the next step is to create what's called a landscape.ini file. Now, the ini file is a text file. It's a text file. You can create it using Notepad, and you need to put text in it along the lines of what I'm showing here. Now, I've put this whole text in the description field on my YouTube video, so you should be able to go there and just select it and copy and paste it, so you don't have to type all this in. But you will need to change some of the entries: the name, author, description. The maptex equals, that must match the file name that you use when you say exported as a PNG. And this angle rotator is important. Set it to 0.0 initially, and then we'll come back and edit that again later. And set the latitude and longitude values to match where your location is, and then save the file. So once the file is saved, you're then going to take your landscape.png and your landscape.ini, select them both, and then right click and do send to compressed zipped folder. That makes a zipped folder. I'm just going to call mine landscape.zip. So now we can run up Stellarium. Okay, with Stellarium up and running, we go to the left hand side and choose sky and viewing options window, and select the landscapes tab, and then add and stroke remove landscapes, the button at the bottom. And I have an old one I'm just going to remove here. So install a new landscape from a zip archive with the tick box switched to new landscape after installation. Click on there, and then you want to browse to your zip file you just created. It's here, there's my zip file. I click open. Hopefully you'll get this message: landscape has been installed successfully. Close that box, close this box, and close this box, and there you go. Your landscape is in Stellarium. Now check it out, make sure it all looks nice, and also turn on your sky brightness simulation. You'll see that when you go from day into night, it actually darkens the landscape. Now, one thing still wrong here, and that is the orientation of the landscape to the compass directions. I'm just going to go back to daytime. I know from my imaging position that north is directly above this alarm box on my house. But if you look, the meridian is over here. It says north is over here, so that's not correct. So what I'm going to do is zoom in on where I know to be north on the image, and you can use a compass for this purpose. And I've got the azimuthal grid turned on, and that's showing me that my alarm box is coming up at about 298 degrees. Instead of at 360 or zero. So it is 62 degrees off. So what I'm going to do is, actually just a couple of other things I've noticed. There are some small bits of debris left in the image here. There's another couple up here. and those are unsightly, that they need to be removed. So what I'm going to do, two things. So remember, we had to make an adjustment of 62 degrees. So the first thing we'll do is go back into the INI file, edit that, and change angle rotates to 62 degrees. You may need to go the other way. That depends which direction you're off by. You're off in east or west of north. So resave the file. Delete your zip file. Reselect the INI and landscape.png file. Right click. Send to compressed zipped folder. Landscape.zip. So I've remade my landscape file. There was some bits of debris to tidy up on the image, weren't there? So we go back into the image. This is why it's a good idea to leave your image open. I'm going to go in here and I can see those artifacts here in the sky. I'm just going to select a nice big area, make sure I don't have any artifacts in those areas. Delete, scroll across to the right, got all of those. Can't see any. Oh yes, there's one here, look, and delete that one, and there's another one up here. Again, just choose a nice big area of sky and delete all that to make sure there's no artifacts in there. And I'll now re-export the image. Landscape.png. Okay, and I will just quickly remake the zip file again because I changed my PNG file into desktop zip. Press folder. Okay. Right, so we can now go back to Stellarium and delete this landscape. Add remove landscapes, remove, yes, okay, and then we're going to add in a new one. Add the new one. Now you will find that this won't make the adjustment that you're expecting. North will still be in the wrong place, and this just puzzled me at first. It doesn't even, hasn't updated the image either, and that's because it's loaded it in at the time that Stellarium runs up. It loads this information in. So although we've got a new a zip file, it's not read it. So what we need to do is close Stellarium and reopen it. I'll just do that. Okay. So Stellarium is back up, and we'll go in and reselect. Landscape. I'm going to set the use this landscape as default. I want it to come up with this landscape every time. And look, the north is now right exactly where I want it, over the alarm box. That's great. And those other artifacts in the image have gone. So that's how you make your own custom landscape for Stellarium. Hope you enjoy making yours, and it works for you. And I hope you found this useful. Clear skies. See you next time.